This game is called Roll 2, 1 to 12. This is the most advanced of the three roll games. The goal of this game is to match and combine the numbers rolled on the dice to turn over all the cards. Later, if children are ready, they can also use subtraction to find the difference between the two numbers. In this version of Roll 2, we'll use two regular 1 to 6 dice and the 1 through 12 cards. So just like in Roll 2, 1 to 6, we'll give each child a set of cards and ask them to put their cards in order. But this time there are a lot more cards. Notice how the children arrange the cards. Do they order them from left to right? Do they leave space between the 4 and the 6 to place the 5 card? There is a lot to think about when laying out the numbers in order. And you can even see here I'm running out of space, so I have to think about what I'm gonna do. I think I'll make 2 rows. Now that the cards are laid out, we'll roll both dice. I got a 2 and a 5, so I can turn over my 2 and my 5, or I can add these together and turn over my 7 card. If kids are ready, you can start playing this game with subtraction. So in the case of my 2 and 5, I could subtract 2 from 5 and turn over my 3 card. Now, when we talk about subtraction, it's very tempting to say that you can't take away a bigger number from a smaller number, that we can't take away 5 from 2. But the thing is, you can. Taking away 5 from 2 gets you negative 3. So we're not going to try to explain negative numbers to most little kids, but we also don't want to give them the misconception that it's not possible to subtract a bigger number from a smaller number. So you might want to say something like, "Yes, you can do that. It's so cool. It gives you a negative number." That's something you'll learn more about when you're older. Playing with subtraction also lets you play with the zero card. So you can include the zero card in your line, and then when you roll doubles, turn it over using subtraction. So here I roll again, and I get a 2 and a 2. My options are, I could turn over my 2, I could add them together and turn over my 4, or I could subtract them and turn over the 0. When playing this version of the game, it helps to start thinking about strategy. So if I get 2 sixes, I might want to turn over my 12 as opposed to my 6 or even my 0, because I know 12 is a difficult number to roll. So you can start helping kids think about what a good move might be and which rolls are more or less rare. There are also a few variations that can make this game even more fun. One is you can play that rolling doubles is a wild roll that lets you turn over any card. You can also play this game with a third die, which gives you more combinations to think about and more ways to combine rolls to make these numbers. Both of these variations can help to make things more interesting, and they help speed things up at the end of the game if you just can't seem to roll one of your numbers. Check out our website for more games and lots of other ways to learn and practice math.